Hello, everyone. It's June 23rd, 2015. It's Tuesday. It's Harp Tuesday. And I know it's been quite a while since I recorded an episode of Harp Tuesday or Slow Motion Monday. Sort of been having a summer holiday. But I'm back. And for this week's episode, I thought I would talk about playing unbroken chords, solid chords. And I think the last Slow Motion Monday video that I did was of four-finger solid chords. And I've actually had a handful of students where we've been working on one aspect or another of playing unbroken chords. And I thought it was worth talking about. So let's adjust this camera angle a little bit. I'm going to zoom in. And let's talk about them. So, of course, you know, we, I guess you can't really see my left hand there. Once we learn how to do it, we often are doing a lot of broken chords. Which is great, you know, beautiful sound, it's, and at varying speeds from a short crack to a big break. But it's also good to make sure that we can still do a solid chord where every note is happening at the same time. And we're hearing each finger equally. And that's hard as well. That's an important skill as well. So I'm going to concentrate on the right hand here and talk about sort of how it feels to me. And that's where, of course, the slow motion videos are interesting because you get to see, for example, what I'm actually doing, which may not be exactly what I feel that I'm doing, right? And so it can be helpful to watch something like that, but it can also be helpful to know what somebody's thoughts are in terms of how they're approaching this. And what I'm going to talk about to start with is sort of the way we're playing the strings, the angle of attack and how it feels. So what I'm looking for is of course not a curling of the fingers. I don't want to end up with my fingers curled like this. And what can happen often is maybe two is closing but four is feeling like it has to go like this. At the same time, I think there's also a danger of like trying to do too much of a big close and extending the fingers too far down. Maybe the wrist ends up popping up a little bit and you feel, you know, maybe you're twisting the hand a little bit and feeling as if, you know, these fingers are so extended. So what I'm looking for is kind of a happy medium. And what you might think is pushing the top of the fingers into the strings. And again, this is all going to depend on your hand size, right? What feels comfortable for you and how your fingers are, how your hand is built. But hopefully a fairly neutral position here, you know, wrist not popping up, wrist at that slight curve here, perhaps. And palm pointing pretty much down and not too far up like this, right? We don't want the palm pointing at the strings. And at the same time, we don't want the palm pointing too far the other direction. We don't want it to be extended too far down like this either. So again, I might think of almost trying to play the strings with these knuckles, right? That I'm jamming the hand into the strings there, and then the fingers are dropping down. And I may have talked about this in the episode on tone, but I think Grungen used to talk about, you know, trying to, for like getting a different tone, a better tone, trying to have this portion of the finger be straight, which I can't do, of course, with my fourth finger, and you may not be able to do with your third, maybe not with your second, but if you need to, and again, like with my longer fingers, it's fine to have them be straight. And again, jamming the fingers in towards the strings and then having the fingers drop down. So we do get kind of that drop down feel, but not with a fully extended finger. So the fingertips are maybe a little closer to the palm, and the palm is a little leveler, so that the wrist is kind of on the same plane as the fingertips. In other words, they're not way down beneath the wrist, they're not way up above the wrist, kind of on the same plane. And then, in terms of trying to get them all to play at the same time, right? That sense of, and for me it's a sense of pushing, I think. So yes, I'm thinking of closing into the palm, but I'm also really kind of thinking of just pushing down on the strings. And then that ends up playing the strings. And oftentimes, of course, we can be worried that this fourth finger is going to grab some of the surrounding strings. And kind of counterintuitively, the more we grip the string, the more flesh that we grab the string with, I think the easier it is to avoid, say, that D. So we're getting a nice grip, putting some nice pressure on the strings. And again, you might experiment, can you just play these bottom three notes at the same time? And that sense of, again, it's not a curl, and it's not a really deep push down. It's just this pushing down the strings towards the, you know, towards the soundboard over here somewhere, and the fingers close, and there's the sound. And listening, of course, for evenness. Are you hearing every finger, right? Maybe we're barely playing two. You can experiment by, say, playing. Of course, that's going to sound a little bit different with a thumb, but. Making sure that we're hearing everything. And again, this is a great spot, perhaps, to do some of those, you know, finger independence things. Or Salzedo conditioning exercises or whatnot, where you're. Maybe coming off. And so you can see how. And again, if you watch a slow motion video, I maybe don't always have my fingers. They aren't always straight, especially maybe some of the inversions. But to me, I get that sense, again, of kind of jamming the top of my hand in towards the strings so that I'm almost going out and then coming back in, right, with a finger angle. And again, if, say, for me, for some of you, right, this octave may be a bigger stretch. If I'm dealing with a bigger stretch like this, for example, I'm still trying to grab with that fourth finger. And that fourth finger, I am definitely thinking a bend on the last joint, right? So that I get a nice grip. And you can see by putting lots of pressure, I'm able to play this one without having to go up, you know, but not hitting that A. I'm almost pulling it out of position, right? Giving me less of a chance of grabbing that A. And of course, a similar thing happens with the left hand, and I'm not set up on this angle to really show you very well, but same idea, that evenness and that sense of balance of not having the fingers feel too extended and not having them feel too high, not having them feel curled, but not also feeling that they're extending too far down, right? We do want to aim towards the base of the palm, but more that push right here off of the string that hopefully gets us a nice even sound and a nice solid unbroken chord. So just a few thoughts on that, and hopefully that was useful, or at least interesting. And I will be back next week with a Slow Motion Monday video, and in 2 weeks I'll see you again for Harp Tuesday. So thanks for watching, and see you in 2 weeks. Cheers.